Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Great question came in. The person was trying to write some VBA code that would go through and find all the non-blank cells in column I and write them to another column, let's say column K. And you'll see here in our data, most of these records are blank, but every once in a while we have a code that's over here. And I love this particular macro because this is one macro that the macro recorder can actually get correct. So I'm going to turn on the macro recorder, tools, macro, record new macro. I'll call it GETCODES, no space, of course, in the macro name, stored in this workbook. We'll click OK. Well, we're going to use some built-in functionality here. I'm going to turn on the auto filter, data filter, auto filter, and then in column I, all the way at the bottom, there's a couple of interesting options, one called blanks and one called non-blanks. So I'm going to choose the non-blanks, and you'll see that we have all the codes there. Now I'll select all of column I and use Control C to copy. Now, interestingly enough, because the auto filter is turned on, we've copied only the visible cells. I need to select one other cell, for example, cell K1, and paste, and I'll get just those cells. Now we'll come back here and turn off the auto filter, and at this point, stop recording. And we'll do a little test here. So let me delete that data over in column K. I'll fill in a few other values here. And run the code. So Alt F8, choose Run. And sure enough, we get our unique list of codes over there in column K. Taking a quick look at the code, it turns on the auto filter. It always goes to field 9 and looks for the criteria of non-blank. Selects the whole column, does a copy, and then we selected K1. It does a paste and turns off the auto filter. Now we could shorten this up just a little bit. For example, instead of selecting the column and then copying the selection, we could just copy the column, and we could also specify a destination as range K1. We don't have to bother to select K1, don't have to bother to paste, and that would all happen in one fell swoop. But still, the macro recorder, even without editing the macro, comes up with something that's going to work very easily. I think when the person asked the question, they were figuring that they're going to have to loop through every single row. But this is one case where the auto filter has the perfect built-in functionality, and rather than write code from scratch, we can just use Excel's built-in functionality to solve the problem. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.